Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Dr. Aisha Munk, a psychologist, neuroscientist, and medical doctor. Today we're diving into a topic that impacts all of us, whether directly or indirectly: addiction and the role of dopamine. Why is it so hard to break habits like smoking, endlessly scrolling through social media, or overeating? And what does the so-called feel-good chemical dopamine have to do with it? In this video, I'll explain what dopamine is, how it's connected to addictive behaviors, and give you examples from both research and everyday life to make this complex topic more relatable. So stay tuned, it's going to be enlightening. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter, a chemical messenger in the brain. It's often called the feel-good hormone, but this is misleading. Dopamine doesn't directly create happiness. It's primarily responsible for motivation and reward, but also for movement, for example. It's a key part of the brain's reward system, which drives us to pursue things essential for survival, like food, social connections, and reproduction. Here's how the reward system works. When we do something pleasurable, like eating chocolate, dopamine is released. This signals the brain that was good. Let's do it again. This is how we learn to repeat rewarding behaviors. The problem arises when substances or behaviors hijack this reward system. Drugs like cocaine, nicotine, and alcohol trigger an excessive release of dopamine, far more than natural rewards like eating or social interactions ever could. Take cocaine, for example. It blocks the reabsorption of dopamine, making it linger in the brain for longer. This creates an intense feeling of euphoria that's difficult to replicate naturally. Over time, the brain adapts. It reduces the number of dopamine receptors or the amount of dopamine released. As a result, the reward system becomes less sensitive and we need more of the substance to achieve the same effect. This is what we call tolerance. Some examples of addiction and dopamine. First, alcohol. Alcohol stimulates dopamine release in the nucleus accumbens, a central area of the brain's reward system. That's why people often feel more relaxed or euphoric after a few drinks. However, chronic alcohol use decreases dopamine activity over time. This is why individuals with alcohol dependency often experience anhedonia, the inability to feel pleasure. Second, nicotine. Nicotine activates receptors directly linked to dopamine release. That's why smokers often feel relaxed or focused after a cigarette. Smoking becomes heavily conditioned. Cues like the smell of smoke or the sight of a lighter can trigger dopamine release and intensify cravings. Third, illegal drugs like cocaine and amphetamines. As mentioned earlier, these drugs amplify dopamine effects dramatically. However, the crash after the high can be so severe that it leads to intensive cravings and compulsive use. Fourth, gambling and social media. Interestingly, addiction doesn't always involve substances. Gambling leverages the unpredictability of rewards, a particularly powerful trigger for dopamine. Social media works in a similar way. Notifications, likes, and comments act as a small, unpredictable reward, keeping us hooked and triggering our dopamine system. Fifth, food and obesity. Certain foods, especially those high in sugar and fat, cause significant dopamine release. This can lead to emotional eating or even food addiction, as the brain perceives these foods as highly rewarding. Addiction doesn't just affect the dopamine system, it alters the entire brain. One area that's particularly impacted is the prefrontal cortex, responsible for self-control and decision-making. Prefrontal cortex is here in front of your head. This means that even when we rationally know a behavior is harmful, stopping it can feel nearly impossible because the reward system keeps tempting us. Here's a real-world example. A smoker sees a cigarette and immediately experiences a dopamine surge, increasing their craving. Even if they try to resist, their brain bombards them with intense urges, making it difficult to say no. Can we retrain the dopamine system? We can do like several things. For example, reducing unhealthy triggers. The first step is minimizing things that overstimulate the dopamine system. This might involve quitting drugs or alcohol or taking a digital detox. Second, strengthening natural rewards. Instead of relying on artificial stimulants, seek out natural sources of dopamine. Exercise, creative hobbies, social interactions, and meditation are all effective ways to restore balance in the reward system. Third, setting long-term goals. Dopamine isn't only about instant gratification. It's also released when we make progress toward long-term goals. Set realistic objectives and celebrate small milestones along the way. Fourth, practicing mindfulness. Mindfulness helps reduce cravings by teaching us to observe them without immediately reacting. This strengthens self-control and supports the prefrontal cortex. Dopamine plays a central role in our reward system, driving both positive and negative behaviors. Addiction occurs when this system becomes imbalanced. The good news? With the right strategies, we can retrain our brains and move toward healthier lifestyles. What are your thoughts on this topic? Do you know someone struggling with addiction or have personal experience to share? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe for more engaging content on psychology and neuroscience. See you next time.